Hi and welcome back. So this is where we stopped in the last video, and in this video let's see how we can edit this form and then take the code and put it on a web page. If you want to edit it, you can just click on where you want to edit, and on this end you see there are different options. You can add a field. If you want to add a field this side, you can add a field. You can even change the size of the form. You can increase the size of the form. And if you just drag something, you see you can drag it and position it. If you want to delete something, just click there, delete. You want to add a name, you can add a name there. So these are all available fields for you, and you can choose any of these and just add it here. Maybe you want to add somebody's website. You can add that there. You can even add images. If you want to add an image, you just scroll, bring it this side, add the image location, and if it's too big, you can increase the size of the form right there. So maybe you don't want all this text. You can delete that. Put your image right there. Reduce the size of this. Maybe change the wording in here. Just click and you can delete that. Maybe say, join the others. Then let me delete all this. I'm just pressing delete on my keyboard and that deletes all of that. Then if I want to position it, I'll just click outside. Just click outside. And then I can just click on it and drag it like that. So I don't need this form. I'll delete this one. You can replace an image. You see here, replace, just click on replace. So you're free to use any of these images which are in here, or you can come to my images, and under my images you'll be able to upload your own images. So right now, let me just use one of these images which are here. Let me choose this light bulb, and you see it replaces the image which was there. So you can also upload your own images. If you just go to my images, you'll be able to browse into your laptop, or if it is in a link on a certain website, you just add that link and you'll be able to use it. So something else, I don't want this button to be here, so I want to bring it this side, and I can increase the length of the button so that it is the same width as these forms, like that. So I also don't want it to say download now. So if I just click here, I can just say join now. That will do. So if you don't like the color of this, you see this side where we say style, you can change the colors. So let's make this some kind of blue. Okay. Then the hover color. When somebody puts their mouse over it, which color do you want it to have? Let's also choose a different kind of blue. Okay. So I don't really want that over there. So I'll just delete it. So you can see that this is a very easy way for you. You can even change the background color of this. Once you click on it, just click outside here and then come and click on styles and background. You can even add a background image if that's what you want. If you want a border radius, you can add a border radius. And if you come back here, there is a border that has been created. There's a radius on the border. So there's a border radius. If I click outside here, you'll see it's much more visible. So here on styles, under styles, you can edit different things. You can change a lot of different things here. There's also this thank you page. That's the form itself here. And then here there's a thank you page whereby once they sign up, you'll give them a message. So since I'm not giving them any download, I can just say thank you. So if you come here to settings, let's see what we have under these settings. Under the form settings, there are also different options. You can change the campaign for this one. If you want the subscribers to go to a different campaign, you'll come here and choose the particular campaign that you want. So if you want confirmed opt-in, they have to confirm that they want to subscribe to your email list. Then they will receive a confirmation email in their email. So if I had cycles that I wanted to add people who subscribe, I would add that here. But right now I don't have any autoresponders. Therefore, this is just redundant. Then you can choose a thank you page. You saw that there is this thank you page here. If I click on it, once they fill the form, then that form will be loaded. But in some cases, you may want to use your own custom page. So let's say you want to use a custom, you can just click custom and then you'll add the full URL. Maybe it's a download page that has a download link for them. You can add that here. Then, if they're already subscribed, maybe you want to take them to a different page and tell them, hey, you already subscribed to my list. You can add a custom link for that. Or if you want them to do something else, maybe you want them to stay on your website. Then, on that page, you tell them you already subscribed to this list, but you can watch the following video, or you can download the following, or you can go ahead and read latest post. So you can add that here. If you want a capture, just add this. I usually find them very annoying, so just turn this off. Choose tracking. You can track the custom fields if you create any custom fields. So here you can add a custom field that you want to track. And then you can forward data. You can create it such that when people post, there are certain forms, maybe you want them also to be forwarded to your thank you page. So if you make any changes here, just click on save. I haven't made any changes and you can see it just brings for me this error. So I'll just cancel. So this video is becoming very long and I don't like to edit long videos. So the next thing, in the next video, what we're going to do is we're going to take the code for this form and we're going to see where we can put it once we publish it. So in this video, you've seen how you can edit a form. So you just choose a form and then you can edit it however you wish. If you want to change the colors of anything, you just click on that element and then click on style. And if you want to change the layout, you'll just come here and change the layout of different things. So that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next video.